So sometimes you just have to be yourself. If you don't have something to talk about, don't go on social media.
Who are you and what do you do?
Okay, my name is Nuruddin. I'm a TV presenter.
I want to know more about your personal experience using live broadcast, especially on Instagram. I've been noticing you've been more and more active in some personal scenarios, getting a haircut or so on. And you're trying to find a way also to interact better with your audience. So tell me more generally, how has your experience been overall?
Let me correct you. I don't usually try to find a better way to interact with my audience, because usually I don't really believe with interaction with the audience more than educating the audience, to be honest. So
can you elaborate more on that point?
Like, if I have something to say about any specific topic, I don't mind to engage the audience, but yet if I have just like, you know, one-way communication with the audience through social media, I don't mind. I just say it. Sometimes I post something on social media and I'm not expecting any interaction. I'm not expecting the audience to reply back to me, for example. And even when I go live, sometimes I just double click on the screen so I don't see the comments. I don't see them commenting because I want to talk about something. And sometimes live broadcast is not about, you know, just discussing a topic. Sometimes it's like you want to just talk about something to someone, to the mass, and you just want to share it. You don't have to interact all the time. Yet, yes, I do agree, like, social media is all about interaction and stuff, but it's not in my dictionary. I don't know. I see it in a different way.
And the part I find a little bit annoying with the live videos is how the comments that they give us, they're usually short by medium. So it's a limitation by medium. They're usually short. They have to type it. It's easier for us. You can just say it easily. Then
That's
they have
true.
To type it.
That's
then you have
true.
To understand this and react. And then if you have one good comment, it's buried by 10
That's
unnecessary
so
comments
well,
and
you
so
can,
on.
You can pen the comment. But the thing is with other people commenting on you, like sometimes it's so silly. Sorry to say this. Like you're discussing something so serious. And then even like people are listening to you. Out of a sudden you see like, hi, where are you from? How old are you? What's your age? You know, silly comments, sometimes they disturb you and they like, it's just like, it's a distraction for the topic as well. And even for people who are watching you live. That's why I started like, once Instagram, you know, introduced the live broadcast, I was an addict. Every single night at 10, I'm live with my audience for like 30 minutes or 1 hour discussing a topic.
Some of them was over dinner as well. I remember.
True.
Yes. After a healthy dinner. Heck yeah.
But nowadays, no, not really. I rarely go live because the audience is... Well, I always believe like you direct the audience. You don't give the audience what they want all the time.
Okay.
This is the way I think, I don't know, as a media person.
Okay.
Because you can redirect them about something, and I've done this before. But then again, like you have a lot of kids on social media, which is, you know, I don't tolerate all the time, to be honest. Sorry, I'm being too blunt.
Okay.
So that's why I rarely go live now. And I don't have topics to talk about. It's not about like every night you have a topic to talk about. No. I'm a human being. I'm not a robot to talk about any new topic. And I don't want to be like mainstream. Like, for example, today there is a hashtag about this football player. I have to comment on it. No, I don't have to. Like, my Egyptian friends were so sad because I didn't comment on a post on social media about, you know, Egypt winning the match. I don't have to. I told you congratulations and stuff. And then I posted something on my story saying, because my Egyptian friends are too sad and they're like, they were so aggressive about it, I'm posting this. Yes, you know, communicating with people is something really nice and Egyptians would appreciate it. And it applies to Saudis sometimes. When they have something against what they believe, they go against you, you know, they go so aggressive with you. And it's annoying.
What have been...
Sorry, I'm being too harsh.
What have been good sessions, Yanni? You did a live video and you left feeling happy, said this was a good session. So what was it? What was the topic about? What was different than other sessions?
Usually when I discuss something related to my personal life, which is something I don't do, I rarely talk about my personal life. I have fibromyalgia, and when I discuss it with my audience on social media, they go like, "Whoa!" You know, they just like it because it's too private. Or sometimes I talk about, you know, things that we face on our daily lives. They love it. But the most interaction sessions I've got, it was like criticizing social media celebrities. They just love it because it's gossiping.
What advice would you have for people who are trying to get better on live broadcast.
Just be yourself, trust me. This is the key thing. Just be yourself. No matter what, just be yourself. Sometimes you want to talk about politics, but you don't have anything to talk about. Just don't talk about politics. I mean, sorry, talk about politics. If you have something to do like with your personal life and you want to share it, just share it. Like a few days ago, I was in a talk about being an influencer, especially in fashion, let's say, on Instagram and something called Simply Dubai. And they were asking me about... what should we do to get more audience? I was like, you don't have to do something to get more audience. It should be organic. You don't have to push it. The more energy you spend on it, sometimes it reflects back. It's not the whole, like, you know, the law of attraction doesn't work all the time. So sometimes you just have to be yourself. If you don't have something to talk about, don't go on social media. People are being so desperate about it. They're like, you know, I don't know. They're so frustrated. They just want to go live and talk about it. I have to post. No, just chill. You have another life. It's not all about the cyber life you live. Wallah! I'm sure you agree. That's why you're smiling.
Thank you, Nordin.
You're welcome.